Today, I'd like to talk to you about infection and how it can impact childhood leukemia risk. First of all, infection. What we know about infections is that our immune system is primed to interact with infections at an early age and primed to interact early and often. We also know that from studying many childhood diseases that a lack of infection can lead to an unmodulated immune system that is then overreactive to our environment. The increased incidence of allergies in our society today is one aspect of this problem. We would like to understand whether infection can impact leukemia risk. We might imagine that it would because leukemia is a disease of our immune system. There are some interesting epidemiologic observations on infections in leukemia. Children who get leukemia tend to be exposed to fewer infections in childhood. So similar to what I mentioned in the last slide, they tend to have lower interaction with their environment as far as childhood contacts in daycare. But what seems a bit paradoxical is that children who contract leukemia tend to have had more doctor visits for infection in their past. So it appears that when they do get infections, even though it's less frequently, they tend to be more severe. I would like to illustrate this paradox with a couple of figures. On the left-hand side of this figure, we see a number of childhood leukemia studies stacked up in a meta-analysis where almost universally these childhood leukemia studies show that children who grow up to get leukemia have lower exposure to other children in daycare. Now, one of these studies, the largest of these studies actually, had another result, which is on the right-hand side of this figure, which seems to be a paradox. And there are two lines on this graph. One of them is red and one is green. The red line refers to children who got leukemia later. What we're looking at are infections recorded in the general practitioner's medical records of these children during the first year of life. The children who grew up to get leukemia were in the doctor's office more often for infections than control children, which are indicated by the green line here. So even though they've had lower exposure to children in daycare, they were in the doctor's office more often for infection. A couple of years ago, we had a very interesting observation that might help to explain this apparent paradox with infection and leukemia risk. What we found when we looked at cytokines at the time of birth is that children who grow up to get leukemia are profoundly deficient in a cytokine called interleukin-10. Interleukin-10 is an immunosuppressive cytokine and one that's very important in a response to infection. What interleukin-10 does is it modulates the severity of the response to the infection. And once the infection is cleared, interleukin-10 will help to turn off the immune system and come back to normality. If one is deficient in IL-10, they may respond to infections much more strongly, and this response may be harmful to the immune system and promote risk to leukemia. What we know about leukemia is that leukemia is a combination of several genetic and epigenetic events, some which occur early in life and some which occur later. What we think may cause a leukemia cluster is some kind of environmental stimulus that would only impact or cause the second genetic and epigenetic events. So there may be environmental causes of clusters which actually impact an entire community, whereas leukemia is only an expression in those individuals who have pre-leukemic mutations. One possible stimulus of clusters is infection. A community may have a low immunity, or a new infection would be introduced into a community, and only those individuals or those children who have pre-leukemic mutations may express leukemia as a response to that infection. This has been studied in research through a topic known as population mixing. Researchers have found that when new communities are developed and children from many regions are mixed together, there tends to be a transient increase in leukemia rates, leading to this population mixing idea. This was demonstrated in new towns in the UK and the United Kingdom. It was also seen after the wall came down in between East and West Germany.